Hey, Most Amazing Top 10 family. I'm your host, Che Dorena. Welcome back to Most Amazing Top 10. I'm really lucky my parents put me in swimming lessons from the time I was a little baby, so I've never had the fear of water, but I know that a lot of people do. I mean, I get it. The feeling of deep water feels a little strange, like you have no idea what is under you. And if you already have a fear of water, then this list isn't gonna make you feel any better, because today I'm bringing you top 10 haunted lakes you should never swim in. As always, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Also, stick around for the whole list because I'm going to be doing some more pet shoutouts, which you guys love so much. If you want me to shout out your pet, then you can hit me up on Instagram. And right before we get into this video, I want to give a quick shout out to our amazing sponsor. Today's sponsor is World of Warships, and this game is amazing. World of Warship uses a plethora of mechanics like rotating weather conditions that will have a strategic effect on all of your ships, and you won't be lacking people to play with. There are over 30 million players worldwide. If you're looking to jump into this amazing game, you can use the invite code BATTLESTATION2020 to get a ton of additional free content. With this code, you will get 250 doubloons, 3 days of premium account access, 1 million credits, a premium ship, the USS Charleston, and a port slot. Check out the description for more details, and the best part about this code is it's for new players looking to jump into this exciting new game. And now let's get into this list. At number 10, we have the Gardner Lake in Connecticut, USA. All right, we're gonna kick off this list with a tale of loss, mistakes, and a bunch of ghosts having a big party thanks to your massive mistake. We have to take a trip back to 1895. There was a man who lived on just the north end of the lake, and for whatever reason, he wanted to move to the south side. He thought it would be better. This is the ultimate grass is greener scenario. Well, legend says he wanted to move to the south side of the lake, but he didn't want to build a new house. He wanted to take his house that he already had and move it all the way to the south side. Talk about trying to have your cake and eat it too. Well, how was he going to do this? It is so much work to move your entire house. I mean, I've seen countless videos on the internet, and it ends with most of them being torn in half. So I think this is something that would be good to avoid, but this guy had a plan. He wanted to wait until winter so he could roll over the frozen lake with his giant house on a sled. A two-story house fully packed with furniture and a grand piano only supported by ice. What could go wrong? Well, you can guess, the house fell through the ice. That's exactly what happened. Now, the guy transporting didn't die in this kerfuffle, but it said that in the middle of the night, you can see the house floating on the lake with all the ghosts of the different bodies that have been left in the lake running in and out of it. Some people say you can even hear ghosts playing the grand piano. At number 9, we have Lake Superior in Minnesota. Ghost boat, that's all I'm gonna say. Well, there'll be a little more, but that's the main point of this. That's right, there is a ghost boat that haunts these waters filled with ghost pirates, and if you can defeat them, you'll be richer than Jeff Bezos's wife after the divorce. But well, half of that I made up. There is really a ghost ship, but it doesn't have all the pirates and stuff on it, and there's no money, but it has been sailing the waters in the moonlight. Apparently in 1985, the boat went down with all of its crew. People have seen the ghost boat still sailing the open water, and there have been some scuba divers that went out to check out the shipwreck, and they said that the wreck was so surrounded by ghosts underwater. There's deep sea ghosts there too. At number 8, we have the Matrox Swamp in Louisiana, USA. I know a swamp isn't really a lake, but they're both like similar bodies of water. And this one is really cool, so I had to put it on this list. This swamp is not only gator infested, but it is also home to a powerful ghost. There was a voodoo priestess who died in the swamp and goes by the name Julia White. She walks through the swamp telling people that she's not dead yet, but when she dies, she's gonna take every soul with her. And if that isn't enough, there's a werewolf that is said to patrol the swamp as well. See, I told you this one was cool, now we can move on to more lakes. At number 7, we have Loch Ness in Scotland. Who in the world doesn't know about the famous Loch Ness Monster? Nessie holds the crown as the king of the underwater monsters. And even though there are hundreds of thousands of people who make the trip over there every year to this lake, there are little to no sightings. Maybe the creature is dead, or maybe it never existed in the first place. But even though people come there for the big sea snake, there are a bunch of ghosts that might start being a nice side attraction. Over the years, plenty of people have drowned in the lake, and there are ghosts now that share the lake with the Loch Ness Monster. Some people have reported seeing ghostly figures standing out of the water staring back at them. That really makes my skin crawl. At number 6, we have Drew University Lake in New Jersey, USA. A university lake. I bet you there's a bunch of university students who make their trip down there to the lake so they can make out in the back of a car. Well, if they did want to use this as a romantic lakeside makeout point, then they might get an unsuspecting visitor come and creep on them. The lake is famously haunted by the Lady in Blue. She is a ghostly figure of a woman wearing a translucent blue dress. Very spooky. It's unknown where this mystery woman originated from, but people have their speculations. Because she is in a beautiful blue dress, it seems she could have been on a date at the time of her death. Maybe she went out on a boat in the middle of the lake with someone and fell in and was unable to swim. Or it could be that someone took her there to kill her. No matter the story, I would recommend avoiding this lake at sunset unless you want to meet her in person. At number 5, we have Lake Tahoe. I love this place because it's haunted by a guy who loved to drink more than he was afraid of dying. And you know that means he was a good time. It was Dick Barter who used to make trips from Fannett Island at the center of the lake to the bars at the south end of the lake and then sail back home all drunk. He was confident that his drinking and sailing would one day kill him, so he built his own tomb on the island. Then one day in 1873, his drunk fears came true and he fell into the lake and died. The bummer is that no one found his body, so his grave is still empty. But it's said that you can find his ghost walking around the island at night trying to find his tomb. At number 4, we have Veterans Lake, Oklahoma, USA. If you don't want to get killed by a couple of ghosts, then you should stay away from this lake. There are legends of a couple of spirits that float around the lake and lure people in. They have the ability to get people to walk into the water and then swim out. And once they've gone to the point where it's too deep, the ghosts will drown you and take your souls and probably hang out with you in the afterlife. Could you imagine you get drowned by a couple of ghosts and then you become a ghost and then there's like an awesome ghost party on the lake with a bunch of people who drowned in the lake? That's like almost worth it. At number 3, we have White Rock Lake in Texas, USA. More ghost ladies. This place is haunted by the soaking wet Lady in White. This isn't an exaggeration. A lot of people have seen her and they all tell the same story. There's a girl dressed all in white. She looks as if she was pulled out of time from a different era, but she's dripping wet, like she jumped into the lake with all her clothes on. She's shivering, scared, and usually needs a ride home. Then as soon as you agree to take her home or as soon as she sits down in your car, she will disappear, leaving behind a wet spot. So if you ever want to try and help her out, put a towel down in your seat. It's gonna mess up your new leather. You want to be a nice guy, but she's still a ghost who's gonna leave a wet spot. It's not. I just got the car. At number 2, we have Lake Ronkonkoma, New York, USA. Oh boy, does this lake have a lot of bad mojo around it. Let's say if you're a dude, even if you're a strong swimmer, you might not want to go for a dip in this lake. There is an ancient legend that has been attached to this lake for hundreds of years. The tale about a Native American woman who fell in love with a settler. Oh my, this is very saucy. They knew that they couldn't be together because back then people weren't really open to interracial relationships at all. I mean, it took Star Trek before we even had an interracial kiss on TV, and thank God we did because now I exist. Well, these two lovebirds decided they didn't care what anyone thought and they went to run off to a faraway land where they could be in love and be accepted. But they didn't get very far before some people caught up with them and her lover was killed in the altercation. She was devastated and she decided that her life without him wasn't worth living. She grabbed some rope and then grabbed the biggest rock she could carry and a canoe and set out to the middle of Lake Ronkonkoma. She then tied one end of the rope around herself and the other end around her trusty rock and then flung herself and the rock into the water, but not before putting a curse on the whole lake. Because her love was taken from her, she decided that once a year the lake would take a young man from someone else, and apparently the curse has held strong for the last 200 years. At least one dude has drowned in the lake every year. That is spooky. At number 1, we have Haunted Lake, New Hampshire. I mean, the place is called Haunted Lake. It's kind of like right on the nose. Of course, this place is the most haunted one. You don't call a place Haunted Lake because there's a big marshmallow factory there and Santa Claus opened up a second workshop. No, it's because there's a bunch of spirits hanging around there who watch you while you sleep and knock things over in your cabins. That's what's going on. The local legend of the lake is that every living thing around the lake was killed brutally. And when I say everything, I mean everything, like animals, trees, people, even bugs. There was a raging forest fire that burned through the area and killed all life. Everyone who passed through the area after the fire said they could smell burning flesh and could feel darkness in the air. Now at night, ghosts come out and you can hear them scream out in pain, trying to escape their never-ending burning torment. Oh, that sounds horrible. All right, everyone, that is our list. And as promised, I'm going to do some more pet shoutouts. Remember, if you want me to shout out your pet, you can message me on Instagram. I pick new pets every day, so if you don't get picked one day, you can message back another day. And if it takes me a while to get back to, I am very sorry. I have so many of these to do. And without taking any longer, let's shout out some pets. First, we have an amazing shot of Casey's super cute dog. Look at how nice that picture is. I love it. Next, Jen sent in a picture of Shadow, black as night and looking super comfy. Then we have a picture of Bella. That is definitely her best angle. Oh my God. After that, Jamie Lynn sent in her hamster Taz. This is the perfect little ball. He's just all like bleh, 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 just bleh. Next, we have Tori's dog Tippy. He's got some big ears and I love it. And finally, we have a beautiful picture of Lucy. Look how happy she is. Very cute, big smile. Beautiful girl. All right, everyone, that has been our list. Thank you all so much for tuning in. As always, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Until next time, I've been Shade Arena, and be careful where you swim.